I'm Jackie YBT, Tech Away Tech Everyday, and today I'm gonna take you a trip down to the memory lane. Apple only launched 4 different generations of iPod Shuffle for its lifetime. This iPod Shuffle is the final and the best iPod Shuffle. With that being said, should you buy this iPod Shuffle 4th generation in 2021? Let's find out. iPod Shuffle 4th generation was introduced on 1st of September 2010. That was 11 years ago, man. Time flies indeed. And about 4 years ago, 27th of July 2017, Apple discontinued the whole iPod Shuffle and the iPod Nano lineup. From 2010 to 2015, iPod Shuffle 4th generation went through 3 times color refresh update. It was originally sold in 5 colors: silver with a black control pad, green, blue, orange, and pink with a white control pad. On 12th of September 2012, Apple updated iPod Shuffle 4th generation with new 7 color options: silver and slate, brighter green, blue, pink, yellow, and purple, as well as a brand new product red edition model. Final color refresh update was on 15 July 2015. Apple released 6 new colors: blue, pink, silver, gold, space gray, and product red. Let's talk about the design. iPod Shuffle 4th gen design is basically a smaller version of iPod Shuffle 2nd gen and combined with 3rd gen voice command feature. And voila, you get this iPod Shuffle 4th generation. I like the compact design. It is so small, it's even smaller than my Seiko 5 automatic watch. What I like the most of this iPod Shuffle design is the clipper, as I can clip on my pants or even my shirt. Especially when you go to gym, you wouldn't want to bring something that is big and heavy while working out, right? So iPod Shuffle 4th gen compact clipper design with lightweight comes in handy. However, there is one downside of its design. Because it is so small, there is no place for my fingers to hold the clipper without accidentally click the back button.
iPod Shuffle 4th gen is actually a very simple device. There's no screen, only button and voice command for you to interact with this iPod Shuffle. The button, they call it the ring button, very simple to use it. Volume up, volume down, forward, backward, play pause button or next or previous song. And on top, this is the on off and shuffle switch. One click is on and you see the LED light here. If you go all the way in, it will be shuffle all your songs, and this button is for the voice command. So just to correct my mistake, this feature is called voice over, not voice command. And when you press one time, it will tell you the song that you're listening right now. If you press twice, it will tell you the battery percentage, and if you long press, it will tell you the playlist. And this is the 3.5 millimeter headphone jack and also the place for you to recharge your iPod Shuffle. And at the back is the clipper design. There's no Bluetooth support, so you only can use the 3.5 millimeter headphone jack to plug in your earphones to listen your music.
Storage wise, there is only one storage capacity, which is 2GB. 2GB can store around 400 to 500 songs, which is fine for me as I don't really store that many songs on my devices. If you want to store over 500 songs, then this iPod is not for you. In terms of battery life, Apple estimates up to 15 hours of battery life when it's brand new. Now, if you want to buy an iPod Shuffle for generation, most probably is gonna be second hand, so you will get a degraded battery. My iPod Shuffle still can last for 6 hours of listening time, which is not too bad consider for its age. For the price, I got mine for 149 ringgit in 2014. You can use that as your price reference. Don't buy it if the price is higher than 149 ringgit.
When you plug in your iPod Shuffle and shows orange blinking light. That means your iPod shuffle is successfully connected to your PC and you can start to sync it with the iTunes. Yeah, and that's how you put songs into your iPod shuffle for generation.
Last but not least, should you buy an iPod shuffle for generation in 2021? Yes, if you like the clipper design and for the collection purpose. Plus, it is so cheap to get one, so why not? No, if you want to store more than 500 songs and you are not an Apple fan, there are many better MP3 players with bigger storage capacity out in the market. So that's about it, guys. Thanks for watching. Remember to give a thumbs up, subscribe, and click the bell icon so that you get a notification whenever I upload a new video. Share to your friends and family. Comment down in the comment section below. Buy me a coffee if you can to support this channel or watch my videos. And as always, I will see you in the next video, guys. Goodbye.